Well, as I mentioned earlier, magnificent day here at Penrith, and the water is absolutely superb. And the Bureau of Meteorology, the Weather Bureau, tell us that these conditions will continue right through until our Interstate Regatta on Sunday. So we've got a great few days rowing ahead. And talking about the days rowing ahead, we've got a 96 race program, a big day with many finals. Now, first race, which will get underway very shortly, is race 234. It's the B final of the under 23 women's single sculls. And our competitors in that event will be from UTS, Victoria Delepita. In lane two, Nagambi, Renee Tattersall. In lane three, Fiona Ewing from Sydney University. In lane four, centre of the field, Eleni Kalamos from Huon. In lane five, Narelle Badnock from Adelaide University. Lane six, Candace Williams from Sydney University. In lane seven, the University of Queensland, Samantha Blanchard. And in lane eight, it's UTS Lauren Tem. Great water, great race, and to take our initial commentary, it'll be Ray Hewitt. What do you think is going to be the form for the day?
Well, we've got some terrific racing with finals to begin with. Our second race of the morning, the under 23 women's single scull A final, John. But first off, we've got the B final of the same event with a full field of eight. Of course, where they finish is important, with under 23 selections yet to be done. And you're just looking at the field there, Delapita, Tattersall, Ewing, Kalimnios, Badnock, Williams, Blanchard, Tem. I think it could be a bit of a lottery, this one, John.
Ray Ebert, you ought to take your head back to Queensland in shame for that pun. Ray, probably worth mentioning, finals today, so we're going to have a lot of presentation ceremonies.
We will, and we really ask the competitors to work with us on the presentations, because the race is only 5 minutes apart still, and we need the competitors to get in quickly after their races and to present themselves to Ann Tucker and be ready to be part of those ceremonies. Of course, they'll all be excited just having won medals, but our first race of the day is just underway, and we can see terrific footage coming from the start. One would think that Narelle Badenoch and Eleni Kalimnios should probably fight out the finish. Badenoch, a under 23 representative at last year's World Under 23 Championships in the women's quad scull. And Eleni Kalimnios also has represented Australia at under 19 level. She's coached by Paul Newbon and has a Tasmanian Institute of Sport scholarship, as Narelle Badenoch has a South Australian Sports Institute scholarship. So those two should be the pace setters, one would think. Candace Williams and Fiona Ewing, both of Sydney University, coached by Deb Fox and Esther Verberg. In the mix there as well, Renee Tattersall from Nagambi, Nev Smith and Bill Day coaching her. University of Queensland, Samantha Blanchard, the evergreen Alan Bromley coaching her. And on the extremities, Victoria Delapita, coached by Zelko Delapita, David Geely and Ellen Randell. And UTS, Lauren Tem, also coached by Ellen Randell, David Geely, and on this occasion, Robin Mackney, the third coach. So a good quality field for the B final of the under 23 women's single scull.
Ray, we're suffering this morning from the problem here at Penrith. We're looking due east, and the rising sun makes it very difficult to see our competitors.
It is that, John, but it's better than having a thunderstorm around. But there's some fantastic photos of sunrises here at Penrith that have been on the Rowing Australia Twitter account, and lots of people have been taking those photographs and posting on the social media, so hashtag be part of it, and we encourage people to keep that up. And plenty of feedback on some of the sensational sunrise photos that have been taken.
Ray, the greatest photo I've seen this time was in the rainy period the other day. We had that rainbow and the crews emerging down the course under the rainbow. Quite a spectacular sight.
And hopefully there'll be a pot of gold at the end of it for some of them, John. And the first race heading through the 500-metre mark now. And as I predicted, Eleni Kalimnios is our leader. Candice Williams doing a great job in second place, just 0.81 behind Eleni Kalymnios. And then Narelle Badenoch. As I said, I thought Kalymnios and Badenoch should probably fight out this finish here. Lauren Tem up in fourth place, then follows Samantha Blanchard, Victoria Della Pita, Renee Tattersall, and Fiona Ewing. Very experienced group of coaches involved here with this under 23B final. As I said, Ellen Randell, Neb Smith's been coaching at Nagambi for more days than he'd like to remember, I'm sure. Deb Fox, Paul Newbon, Narelle Badenoch, I imagine, is either coached by Jared Shah or Jason Lane at the South Australian Sports Institute. Again, Deb Fox. Alan Bromley, as I said, has been coaching, was involved coaching me well back in last century, John. And Alan Randell and Robin Mackney also involved in UTS with Lauren Tem. But it, no doubt that Eleni Kalymnios has got out and led through 500, and she and Badenoch will be the testing material, I would think.
Ray, perhaps while this B final is coming down, I might mention that our next race, which is race 235 on the program, this will be our first A final for the day. And it's the under 23 women's single scull. And of course, after the race, it will be our first formal medals presentation of the day. But the start list is in lane one, Madeleine Farrar from ANU. Lane two, Leah Saunders from Sydney. Lane three, Amy James from Toowong. Lane four, Molly Goodman from Adelaide. Lane five, Cara Krasvik. I'll get it right. Give me a correct pronunciation.
Grzeskowiak.
Sorry, Clara, but that's it. Grzeskowiak it is, from Capital Lakes in the ACT. In lane six, it's Rowena Meredith from Mosman. In lane seven, it's Georgina Gotch from Mosman. And in lane eight, Tessa Carty from Bundaberg. That is the A final, the race about to get underway. But the race underway at the moment is the B final. Ray.
Yes, and still Eleni Kalymnios leads from Candice Williams. And the A final is just underway. And ladies and gentlemen, we will bring you broadcast of the A final, a race for medals. And we will hark back to the B final as they go through each timing mark, so we can give you an informed view of that. Kalymnios through the 1,000, 4 minutes 02.4, just 0.69 in front of Candice Williams. Then follows Narelle Badenoch and Renee Tattersall. In the A final, Madeleine Farrar in ANU in Station 1. Renee Domaschens is her coach. Lane 2, Sydney N. Swiss Leah Saunders, Lachlan Carter, Donovan Seck, and Jason Baker coaching there. Toowong, Amy James, the lightweight Amy James in Station 3, coached by Alex Field and Kieran Dwyer. Molly Goodman in Station 4, Adelaide National Training Centre, Canberra. Her national team coach for the year ahead will be Bill Tate, where she'll be rowing in the pair with Jen Horton. And Lane 5, Capital Lakes, Australian Capital Territory Academy of Sport. Cara Grzeskowiak, she's coached by the head coach at ACTAS, Andy Randall. Mosman Rowena Meredith, coached by Alfie Young. Mosman N Swiss Georgie Gotch, also coached by Alfie Young. And in lane 8, nearest to the grandstand, Bundaberg Queensland Academy of Sport, Tessa Carty, coached by the QAS head coach Tom Westgarth. And through 1500 in the B final, Candice Williams has moved to the lead now. Candice Williams, 6.07.51, over Eleni Kalymnios, Narelle Badenoch, and Renee Tattersall. So the top four have been in those places, or in the top four the whole way. The order has changed just a little. Samantha Blanchard back up into fifth, Fiona Ewing sixth, Lauren Tem seventh, and Victoria Della Pita is in eighth place. As we come to 500 metres in the A final, and it is lane eight, Bundaberg Tessa Carty that leads there, 1 minute 53.07. She's 1.03 in front of Molly Goodman. Then follows Georgie Gotch, Cara Grzeskowiak, Leah Saunders, Madeleine Farrar, Rowena Meredith, and Amy James is at the rear. So they've got away quickly, and the little lightweight Amy James has been dropped in the early stages there, which is quite a surprise, because she normally gets out hard. And she's got a lot of work to do now to catch her much bigger rivals in this event, headed up by Tessa Carty, the Bundaberg Queensland Academy of Sport sculler. Molly Goodman, better known as a sweep rower, it's fair to say, but she won a semi-final yesterday and she's second through the 500 metres, so we'll look to a good performance from Molly. And Georgie Gotch also has a history in sweep rowing, is currently in third place as the B final draws to its conclusion. And Eleni Kalymnios has sprinted back to the lead again now. I was surprised that she wasn't in the lead through 1500. And Eleni Kalymnios in lane four will win the B final. Second will be the Sydney Uni sculler in station six, Candace Williams. Third will be station five, Narelle Badenoch. Fourth will be station seven, Samantha Blanchard. Then follows Sydney Uni's Fiona Ewing, Nagambi's Renee Tattersall, Lauren Tem of UTS, and Victoria Della Peter of UTS. So the A final, of first race today for medals. We had two races for medals yesterday, one by Gavin Bellis and Kat Ross, respectively, and through 1,000 metre mark now, and it's Cara Grzeskowiak who's gone to the lead. Cara Grzeskowiak did a great job in the New South Wales Championship. She finished in the A final there of the Open Single Scull, which got her an invitation to the Australian Senior A selection trials. She is eligible for Senior B or under 23. So a terrific effort from her, but the more experienced rivals just a little too strong for her at the Senior A level. But here in the under 23 Single Scull A final of the Australian Championship, she's gone through the 1,000 in 3:52.28. Just 0.8 clear of Tessa Carty, Bundaberg QAS. And Amy James must have spent some petrol in the second 500 to come from eighth up into third place. Then follows Leah Saunders and Georgie Gotch. And Molly Goodman has dropped well back into sixth place. Then follows Rowena Meredith and Madeleine Farrar. So we'll have to watch this race closely, John. They're a bit up and down, and it's difficult to keep an eye on them all. But certainly, Molly Goodman, yes, in station four, has dropped back a little. So the race is on in earnest out here. Grzeskowiak in the middle there in station five. Way out on this side, Tessa Carty doing a terrific job. I don't know that she showed that much form in her heat row, but semi-final she was in fourth place, and she's making a bold bid to be on the dais here for the medal presentations. Leah Saunders has moved right through as well. And it's now Grzeskowiak, Saunders, Farrar, Gotch, Carty, Meredith, Goodman, and back to Amy James again. So we really need to keep an eye out this window and see what's happening. So I'm suggesting that Cara Grzeskowiak is our leader. I think Amy James is well up there in station three. Out on this side, Georgie Gotch and Tessa Carty are in the mix as well. And Leah Saunders in station two is very much in the mix also. So Cara Grzeskowiak, coached by Andy Randall at the ACT Academy of Sport, in the middle of the field, and the semi-final winners, Grzeskowiak and Goodman. Grzeskowiak's at the lead and Goodman struggling today. As I said, better known as a sweep rower, but has done a terrific job to make a way through to the final. But it's Grzeskowiak in the lead. Amy James may be the danger. The lightweight over there in station three. Then on this side, Georgie Gotch is coming into it as well. And Grzeskowiak under attack for all around as Cara Grzeskowiak holds the lead. Amy James finishing strongly in the green boat on the far side. This side, Georgie Gotch, coached by Alfie Young, is looking to get a place in the medals. And over this side further, Tessa Carty now has paid the price for that early effort. Cara Grzeskowiak's led most of the way. She and Amy James are stroke for stroke now in the under-23 women's single scull A final. And the little lightweight from Toowong, Amy James has got a bow in front of that, coached by Alex Field and Kieran Dwyer. And she's making every post a winner now. And Amy James will win the under-23 single. Amy James first, Cara Grzeskowiak second, Georgina Gotch third. Leah Saunders will be fourth. Then Rowena, Meredith, Tessa Carty, Molly Goodman and Madeleine Farrar at the rear.
Oh, what a great sprint to the finish there, and the unofficial time for that race, the under-23 women's singles scull A final, 7:50.34. And unofficially, it's Amy James for Toowong in first place, followed very closely by Cara Grzeskowiak from Capital Lakes, with Georgina Gotts from Mosman in third place. Winning time 7:50.34.